Thanks for taking a couple of minutes to let me update you on what's happening in the legislature. It's hard to believe that this is the fourth week already. Four full weeks gone and 11 to go. So, you know, I'm looking forward to getting back to Eastern Washington. The weather over here is dull and gray, as you might imagine. It's that time of year, and you know, there's just nothing like being on the other side of the mountains. So in our caucus this year, the Senate Republican caucus, we're really concentrating most of our time on the budget. That's really what we're over here for this year. And specifically inside of the budget, not only are we trying to get a sustainable budget, but we're trying to reform the way that we deliver services to the people in the state of Washington. One of the things that we did this year was send an email out to all state employees asking for their input on ways that we could perform our services better to the people in the state of Washington, whether they be good or whether they be bad. We asked them to either do it anonymously. They didn't have to give their name. They could just leave these if they wanted, or they could give their name and the agency that they work for. Because we did that, we got 8,000 responses back. So now we have all of these processes we have to go through to make sure that these are valid and viable. But I tell you, some of the tips that we got from the people on the street were absolutely incredible. So this week we're working on the supplemental budget. That's the budget between now and June 30th of this year. You've all heard it's in a mess. And because there was no time this year, because we asked for a special session and didn't get it, now we have to balance the budget in a very short period of time. That's between now and June 30. And quite frankly, it's very, very difficult. Even if we were in the majority this year, the time frame is so close now, we wouldn't have been able to balance the budget either. So consequently, working with the Democrats and us together, we're going to come out of here with about $300 million of unbalanced budget, which means literally we have to kick it into the next biennial budget. So it just makes the next biennial budget that we start working on $300 million worse. You know, it's been very frustrating for me personally to call for special session after special session. For 4 years now, we've been saying, look, this crash is coming. Nobody listened. And so the crunch is here, and the decisions that we're going to have to make are very difficult. So we, as we move forward into the next biennial budget, we're going to be looking for those ways that I was talking about balancing the budget, getting some permanent closure on some of the programs or some of the policies that maybe have been passed down here but have not been funded. So those are going to be very difficult choices. There are going to be a lot of people upset with this year, but you know, we literally do not have any choice. So thanks for taking a few minutes. I'm hopeful to get back to you next week and let you know more specifically on the bills that we're working on and what we're trying to do to help save you, the taxpayers, money in the state of Washington. Thank you.